Aquatic invasive species are plants and animals that are not native to Minnesota, but can take hold and spread across our waterways, causing harm to ecosystems, the economy, and even human health. Minnesota's natural resources, and especially our lakes, rivers, and streams, are threatened by a number of aquatic invasive species. Zebra mussels and Eurasian water milfoil are spreading at increasing rates throughout our waterways, and they can create hassles for people trying to enjoy the outdoors. Additional costs to manage AIS and the impacts on recreation can change the waterfront experience for shoreland owners. Research shows that once a body of water has an abundance of invasive species, there can be as much as a 19% negative impact on property valuation. Aquatic invasive species can be spread from one water body to another when people, equipment, and things like bait are transported between the two locations. For example, boats and boat ramps are prime locations of increased risk when it comes to spreading invasive species. If weeds and other debris aren't effectively removed from a boat before transporting it, there are risks of spreading AIS. However, equipment that many shoreland owners use on their property can also present risks in spreading AIS. Anytime you pull equipment out of the water or put an item into the water, you risk spreading an aquatic invasive species. For this reason, it's imperative that you consistently follow best practices when putting in or taking out any items from the water. Every shoreland property owner who moves or stores equipment must take responsibility for reducing the risks of spreading AIS. When removing boats, docks, lifts, or other water-related equipment from lakes and rivers, you need to carefully inspect them. Make sure there are no aquatic invasive species such as zebra mussels, Eurasian water milfoil, or New Zealand mud snails attached to any part of the equipment. In addition, Minnesota law requires docks and boat lifts to be out of the water for at least 21 days before putting them in another body of water. Keep this rule in mind if you're going to move equipment onto or off of your property. Look on the posts, wheels, and underwater support bars of docks and lifts, as well as any parts of boats, pontoons, and rafts that may have been submerged in water for an extended period. In newly infested waters, adult zebra mussels may not be abundant, and you might notice only a few mussels on your equipment. If you think you have discovered an invasive species that has not already been confirmed in your lake, contact your area DNR aquatic invasive species specialist. Early detection for zebra mussels is important in protecting your property and Minnesota's water resources. If you hire a business to install or remove your boat, dock, or lift, or other water-related equipment, make sure they have completed AIS training. Service providers that have completed DNR training and obtained their service provider permit will have a permit sticker in the lower driver's side corner of their vehicle's windshield. This signifies that they have completed training on AIS laws, and many have experience removing invasive species. You can find a list of permitted service providers on the DNR website. As a shoreland owner, we need your help to stop the spread of AIS. Learn about invasive species that are in your area and what they look like. Keep your eyes open for anything that's new or different so that we can maintain healthy waters that are valued by everyone.